Dear students, all is well. Today we are going to start second part of the chapter heat. In this chapter we will learn transfer of heat, method of heat transfer, conduction, convection, radiation and application of conduction, convection and radiation. Here are some points about transfer of heat. Why there is a need of transfer of heat? Why heat gets transferred? Heat gets transferred due to the difference in temperature. Heat flows from a body at a high temperature to a body at a lower temperature to maintain the temperature at equal level. When the temperature reaches at equilibrium, then the flow of heat stops. This is the reason heat transfers. Heat transfers through conduction, convection, and radiation. These are the three methods through which the heat transfers. Let us discuss first method of transfer of heat, that is conduction. In this method, molecule does not move. Without molecular movement, heat gets transferred from hotter part to the colder part of the object. Here you can see the heat from the flame is passing to the vessel kept on it. So we can say that in conduction, the heat transfer through contact. Do all objects around us transfer the heat through contact, or some are there which cannot do this? Yes, there are different type of objects. Some, they are good conductor of heat. They allow the heat to pass through them. Example, iron, aluminium, copper. And some are there which do not allow the heat to pass through them easily. Example, wood, plastic, glass, rubber, air, etc. This is the reason the handle of pan is made of plastic or wood to avoid the burn caused by metal, which is a good conductor of heat. Let us discuss the second method of transfer of heat, that is convection. In this method, molecules move from their position to transfer the heat. This method takes place in liquid and gases. Let's take the example of water boiling in a pan on a flame. Water near the base of pan heats first, and then they transfer the heat to the upper molecule by moving from their position. Water molecules move up and transfer the heat to upper molecules. After transferring the heat, the colder molecule sink back to the bottom layer. In this way, the transfer of heat continues and all the water gets heated. The method in which molecules move to transfer the heat is called convection. Dear students, do you know where the convection is very common in nature? It is commonly seen in coastal areas. Convection currents are the main reason for the land bridge and sea bridges in coastal areas. In the day when the sun is up, the land heats up very quickly and the air above it is warm more than the air over the water. The warm air over the land start rising up, and the cold air from the sea moves towards the land, which is called sea breeze. And this situation get reversed at the night time. Night, the cold air blows from land towards the sea. That's why it is called land bridge. Students, can you imagine how the heat from sun reaches to us? It reaches to us without any medium, through the radiations. The third method of transfer of heat is radiation. In this method, the heat transfer without any material medium. There are many examples around us in which the heat transfer through radiation, that are bonfire, heaters, in which the heat transfer through radiation. Here are different applications of transfer of heat through radiation. Different colors absorb different amount of radiations. Dark colored surface radiate more heat than light colored surface. We wear dark colored clothes in winter because it absorbs more heat and keeps us warm. We wear light colored clothes in summer because they absorb less heat and keeps us cool. There are many examples in which the heat passes through radiation. Heat from the fire transfer through radiation. Even the room heater, which we use in winter season, gives the heat through radiation. Here is a vacuum flask. It is known as a thermos. It's used to keep cool things cool and hot things hot, such as hot coffee or cold water. The silver coating on the inner bottle prevents heat transfer by radiation, and the vacuum between double wall prevents heat moving by convection. The thinness of glass walls stop heat entering or leaving the flask by conduction. The case surrounding the flask provide additional insulation. This is way we can get the material at the same temperature as we pour in it. It is an example which shows all three mode of heat transfer: radiation, conduction, convection. With this, the explanation part of the chapter is complete. Now let us have quick recap of the chapter. Our senses of touch enable us to decide whether an object is hot or cold, but it is not always reliable. Temperature is a measure of degree of hotness and coldness of an object. Temperature is measured by a device called thermometer. Thermometer that measures body temperature is called clinical thermometer. Thermometer that is used to measure surrounding or object temperature is called laboratory thermometer. The normal human body temperature is 37 degrees Celsius. Heat always flows from hotter object to a cold. There are three ways in which heat can flow from an object to another. These are conduction, convection, and radiation. With this, we have completed chapter. Now, after this, we will be sharing question answers of the chapter. Till then, take care and have a nice day ahead.